Hey, what's up guys, Tanmay here for Simple Snippets and I'm back with another video tutorial that is on operational research, and we are going to be discussing another assignment problem which is slightly different than the previous video. So if you haven't checked the previous video, you can have a look at it and I'll put the link in the comments or the description section, and you can see all the link on the screen as well. So this assignment problem is slightly different and let's see the steps. And if you don't know the steps or you have missed the first video, it's okay because we are going to be solving this sum from the scratch. So here are the basic steps of the assignment problem. In general, assignment problem arises when we have to allocate certain resources and we have certain options. So we have to optimize it and we have to allocate these resources in the best possible way, reducing the cost or time. So the way we go about solving this problem is we have to create a table, and the rows and columns will denote the different types of jobs as well as the different type of men or workers that we assign to a particular job. In the step one, we select the minimum element or minimum value of a row and subtract it from each element of the same row. For the step two, we select minimum element of a column and subtract it from each element of the same column. Step three, we draw minimum number of lines covering all the rows having zeros. So we have to cover all the zeros using minimum number of lines, and you'll see this when we solve the numerical. So if the number of lines drawn is equal to n, that is equal to the number of rows or number of columns, then the solution is optimum and we'll find the solution using the zero assignment, which you'll see in the numerical. Else we select the minimum number of uncovered elements, subtract it each from the uncovered elements and add it to the intersection of two lines. And I know it sounds confusing, but when we see the numerical, you'll easily understand what is exactly happening. So let's go ahead and solve the numerical. Okay, so as you can see on the screen, here's the question. An automobile dealer wishes to put 4 repairmen to 4 different jobs, and the dealer has to estimate the number of man hours required for each job combination. So our aim is to assign exactly one job to each person so that the total time or cost, in this case it is time, required to complete all the jobs is minimum. So these are the jobs 1, 2, 3, 4 as represented in the first row, and the first column are the different type of persons. So this is man 1 or man 2, or person 1, person 2, so on and so forth. And these values, that is 5, 3, 2, 8, are the number of hours required for person 1 to complete job 1. And this would be 3 hours required for person 1 to complete job 2, so on and so forth. So as per the first step, we have to select the minimum from the first row, and the minimum value here is 2. So we'll subtract 2 from each of these values. So 5 minus 2 would give us 3, 3 minus 2 would give us 1, 2 minus 2 would give us 0, and 8 minus 2 would give us 6. For the next row, we see the minimum value, which is again 2 over here. So we subtract 2 from each of these values. So 7 minus 2 would be 5, then we have 9 minus 2 would be 7, we have 0 again, and we have 4. So I'll just repeat it for these two rows as well. So in this case, the minimum value is 4, subtracting 4 from each of these values, 2, 0, 1, 3, and subtracting 5 from this entire row, we get 0, 2, 2, 3. Now the step 1 is done and we'll move to step 2. So in the step 2, we have to observe each and every column and find out the minimum value out of the column and subtract it from each value of that column. And we have to apply this for the new matrix that we found, or the new table that we've just formed. So for this column, we know that the minimum value is 0. So subtracting 0 from each of these values would give us the same value. So let's move to the next column. So let's see for the column 2. Now column 2, again we have one more 0. So subtracting 0 from each of these values will end up with the same value. So we'll keep it unchanged. For column 3, again we have the minimum as 0. And for column 4, in this case we have the minimum value as 3. So we have to subtract 3 from each of these values. So after doing that, we'll end up with the value of 3100. Okay, so the step 2 is done. Now for the step 3, we have to cover all these zeros with minimum number of lines. So this could be our first line, which covers 2 zeros. This could be our second one, which again covers 2 of these zeros. And to cover these 2 zeros, I'll draw a vertical line. And as you can see, all the zeros are covered. But in this case, the number of lines is equal to 3, which is not equal to number of rows or number of columns, which is 4. So the solution is not optimum. So we have to still do certain operations to make it optimal. And the way we go about it is, we have to select the minimum uncovered element. So the minimum value that is uncovered in this case by the lines is this value, that is 1. So that is the minimum value which is not covered by any of the line. So we have to subtract it from each of the uncovered elements and add it to the intersection of the lines. That means now we know that 3, 5, 7, 3 and 1 are basically uncovered, or they are not covered by the line. So we have to subtract 1 from all these values and this value as well. And we know that this value and this value is the value where the lines are intersected, or where two lines meet. So we have to add 1 to these values. So let's go ahead and perform these operations and we'll find a new matrix. So first we'll subtract it from the uncovered elements. So 3 minus 1 would give us 1 minus 1 would give us 0. We have to leave this as it is. Then again 3 minus 1 would give us 2. 1 minus 1 would give us 0. Leave this value as it is. 7 minus 1 would give us 6. 5 minus 1 would give us 4. Now these places where we have only single line passing through the value, we have to keep it unchanged. So these values will remain unchanged. Now for these two values where the two lines intersect, we have to add the minimum value, that is 1. So here it would be 2 and again it would be 3. So this is the extra step that we need to perform when the number of lines, or the number of lines covering all the zeros, is not equal to the number of rows, that is 4. So now again we have to try and cover all the zeros using minimum number of lines. So let me just try out. So I'll use one line to cover this two rows or two zeros, and use this single line to cover again two row or two zeros, and I still need two lines to cover all the zeros. So in this case, number of lines is equal to 4, which is equal to number of rows, that is also equal to 4. So now we can see that the solution is optimum, and we can assign it by using the zero assignment. So let's say for first row I select this zero. So now I cannot select this zero and I cannot select this zero, because the entire row and the column gets cancelled. So for this row I'll select this zero. So again this zero gets cancelled. For the third row I cannot select this zero, because I've used the zero in that same column. So I have to select this by default. And for the last row I'll select this zero. So the zero assignment process is done. So now just we have to check the original question. So the place, that is 1, 2. So by this, person 1 will be assigned to do job 2. Person 2 will be assigned to do job 3. Person 3 will be assigned to do job 4, and person 4 will be assigned to do job 1. Now this is how we assign the jobs, but what about the final total of number of hours that is required to do all these jobs? So for that we just need to find out the values at these locations in the original table. So we know the original table as follows. So we know this is 3 plus 2 plus 7 and 5. So adding all these values we'll get 17. So the minimum number of hours, let me just write it over here. So the minimum number of hours required to complete all the jobs is 17 hours. So this is the final answer. So that's it for this video. I hope you understood the numerical, and if you have any doubts or queries, you can always put them in the comment section. Let me know how this video was in the comment section as well. And if you like it, do give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Peace.